tongue and hold my breath. Scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I sit quietly, agree politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up. Already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now. I got the eye of the tiger. The fire, dancing through the fire. Cause I am a champion. And you're gonna hear me roar louder. Louder than a lion. Cause I am a champion. And you're gonna hear me roar. You're gonna hear me roar.
Now I'm floating like a butterfly. Stinging like a bee, I earned my stripes.
everybody runs, you choose to stay. I hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. When the moment comes, you'll say, I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say, I lived.
Good evening. On behalf of Dr. Lashley, President of MACC, the Board of Trustees, the faculty and staff, I want to welcome everyone here this evening. Thank you for joining us. We're here to take a moment and celebrate the accomplishments of these nursing students. We're doing it in a little bit different manner. Typically, we'd all be sitting in the auditorium in the Moberly campus, celebrating these students with them sitting up front and the families behind. But really, this experience as a virtual pinning ceremony is really positive and gives us an opportunity. There's things that I like about it even more than the live ceremony. It gives us an opportunity to see the students with their families and friends, the people that have been important to them and supported them throughout this program. You can see the students are already providing support to one another just as they have all the way through the program by following their chats and comments in the chat box in Zoom. It's been fun to watch that. I think that last quote, that it always seems impossible until it's done. They said it was anonymous, but I think that's probably a quote that can be attributed to most every one of us in this room tonight. We've probably all said that at some point in time. The other piece of this is that all of you that are joining the students in this celebration probably didn't completely realize what you were signing up for when the students entered nursing school. And so I'd like to take a moment now and thank all of the family and friends of the students that provided support and encouragement and just the help needed for the students to get through this very rigorous program. I want to thank all of you for joining us tonight, and thank you for the support you gave our students to allow them to be successful in the pursuit of their goal. We know that this is a very rigorous and challenging program. I've seen the work they do. I've talked to the faculty. I know the standards that the instructors set for their students. And it is a tremendous accomplishment to end, to get through this program and become a nurse. You may not have realized it when you started this program, but you are graduating in the midst of a pandemic. When is nursing more important than it is right now? We see that in the news every single day. And I personally am very happy to know that MACC graduates are going to go out and help us get through this situation and get back to a life that's somewhat normal. And that they'll be able to care for us and protect us as they enter their new career. So congratulations, graduates. Thank you, everyone, for joining us this evening. And let's get on with the celebration. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jason Lowry. I am the student class president of the PN program for 2020. I would like to first thank everyone and introduce the administration and faculty from Moberly Area Community College for the practical nursing pinning ceremony. First is Dr. Todd Martin, Vice President for Instruction at Moberly Area Community College. Ms. Michelle Fry, Dean of Health Science at Moberly Area Community College. Mrs. Cheryl Leibarger, Director of Health Science at Moberly Area Community College. Ms. Terry Bixel, Professor and Practical Nursing Coordinator at Moberly Area Community College. Mrs. Anna Blackford, Associate Professor for the Practical Nursing Program at Moberly Area Community College. And Mrs. Denisha Sullivan, Assistant Professor for Practical Nursing Program at Moberly Area Community College, as well as Mr. Sidney Neeb, Administrative Assistant for Health Sciences.
Good evening. Pinning ceremonies are always one of my favorite time of year. It's exciting and rewarding to welcome new graduates into the profession of nursing. To the students, this has been a year-long endeavor, packed full with 51 credit hours of content and clinical experiences, focusing on both the art and the science of nursing. You have learned everything from how to make a bed to analyzing fluid and electrolytes. You have learned to care for individuals throughout the lifespan, from miraculous birth to peaceful death. You've been through one of the most challenging and demanding programs, nursing school. It was difficult. There were many struggles along the way. Unit exams, skills checkoffs, medication administration, final exams, HESI exams, IV therapy, clinical paperwork. Oh, and don't forget, you had to do all of this in the midst of a pandemic. You were stressed and tired, sometimes anxious. You laughed, you cried, but you survived and you were successful. You bonded with your peers and supported each other along the way. Treasure that bond that you have. Those graduating with you today, while not with you in person, are your peers, your study buddies. You will forever be linked by this bond, this year-long agonizing journey that you took together. But you did it. And we are so proud of you for your persistence, your dedication, your determination to not let even COVID keep you from completing your goals. For many of you, this will not just change your life, but the future of your family. For some of you, you're the first in your family to attend college. Some of you have children of your own. You have set the example that nothing that's worthwhile comes easy and that you must set goals and never stop until you reach them. You will leave MACC and start your nursing careers. You might be nervous about entering the workforce without your clinical instructor by your side. Remember to advocate, not just for your patients, but for yourself. Ask questions, ask for help, seek understanding. never stop learning. Find a mentor that will help you transition into that role of the nurse. You have gained a great deal of scientific knowledge throughout this year so that you can safely care for individuals in our community. But I challenge you to always remember why you wanted to be a nurse in the first place. Remember the art of nursing, the art of caring and empathy. Lastly, remember that nursing is a profession bound by ethical standards. Nursing is the most trusted profession. Your patients trust and believe in you. It's a difficult profession, but it's very rewarding. A great deal is expected of you: knowledge, caring, and character. As Carolyn Jarvis stated, the character of a nurse is just as important as the knowledge that he or she possesses. As I stated, many of you will leave MACC and enter the workforce, while some of you may stay at MACC and pursue an associate degree in nursing through our accelerated program. Or you might do both. Whatever you choose, remember that being a nurse requires lifelong learning, whether that is through formal education or through self-growth and conferences. Never stop learning. You are the future of nursing. You have proven that you have the grit and persistence. Now go out into the world and make a positive impact, not just for nursing, but for healthcare in general. We are so proud to call you MACC nurses. Good luck and congratulations, class of 2020.
At this time, I would like to start presentations of awards. And I feel like this is a very important part of our ceremony this evening, because these students have worked very hard during this school year, and they've also accomplished a lot. So the practical nursing faculty would like to take this opportunity to recognize each one of you for the perseverance and your dedication that you have demonstrated throughout this year. You are commended for your hard work and never-ending effort. We wish you the best in your nursing career and your endeavors. At this time, presentations of awards will be announced for those students who resided on class committees, that were on the president's and dean's list at MACC, or were received scholarships throughout this year. And also at this time, after I'm done with the awards of each student, Mrs. Blackford will read thank yous that the students have written to family and friends that supported them throughout this program. And at that time, family members in their homes will pin the students. I would just like to say that the president's list is a list of students who have achieved a grade point average of 4.0 for 12 or more semester hours, and that has been completed for fall and spring session. Qualifying students each session earn the honor of being placed on the prestigious president's list for that semester. The dean's list recognizes those students who have achieved a grade point average of 3.5 to 3.99 for 12 or more credit hours that have been completed in fall or spring. Qualifying students for each session earns the honor of being placed on the esteemed dean's list for that semester. This evening, we have an academic excellence and a clinical excellence that will be presented during tonight's ceremony that this will be a surprise to the students. As I announce your name, please turn on your video or camera so you can be recognized for your accomplishments during this academic year. Once the next student's name is called, then you can turn off your video or camera. Randy Joe Ames. Randy served on the cheer committee for the practical nursing class.
Randy is being pinned by her mother, Becky Ames. Randy wants to say thank you to her mom, who has been there for Randy through one of the toughest years of her life and has always been there to help. Thank you for keeping Randy motivated and on track through everything. Randy also wants to thank her sister and dad for doing whatever they could do to help make this year easier and pushing her to do better. Randy says thank you to her boyfriend Jackson, who has been there to put up with her through all the breakdowns, tears, stress, and has been there to push her and keep her focused. Randy says she couldn't have done it without all of your support. Graduate practical nurse, Randy Ames.
Brooke Branch. Brooke was on the president's list for spring semester 2020, and Brooke served on the historian committee for the practical nursing class.
Brooke has been pinned by her fiance, Nathan Hillard. Brooke would like to thank all of her family and friends for their support and love through this journey. Brooke says she couldn't have done it without all of you. Graduate practical nurse, Brooke Branch. Caitlin Edwards. Caitlin is being pinned by her boyfriend, Nathan Polhill. The following is a letter from Caitlin. Dear family and friends, I want to write this note to thank each and every one of you for all of the love and support given during this last year. I'm going to get straight to the point and start acknowledging all the people I'm thankful for. I want first to start out by giving thanks, the biggest thank you possible, to my classmates. Without each and every one of you, I wouldn't have had the opportunity to make a second family away from home. I am thankful for all of the late night texts, questions, and all conversations that have happened within the last 365 days. Next, all of my professors deserve a big round of applause for putting up with each of us this long. Not only did they put up with us, but they sincerely gave their all to each of us to give each of us the education that we came striving for when we mailed in our applications. I want to say thank you to all of MACC for making this journey the most educational for me. Lastly, I'm thankful for the classmates that have become lifetime family. This is a journey I will never forget. I now want to thank all of my family for all they have given to me. Start out by thanking Nathan for consistently sticking by my side throughout this process, as well as ensuring that I was always taken care of no matter the struggle. I truly wouldn't have been able to pull this degree off without you by my side. I next want to thank my parents for always supporting me and pushing me to never give up. They've always had my back, and I'm thankful they pushed me so hard to achieve this goal. I want to thank all three of my sisters for always supporting me. Whether they understand the process or not, they're always there to hype me up and push me towards my dreams. I also want to give a thank you to my best friend, Danielle. She always made sure that I allowed myself time to take care of me. She supported me through every decision, and for that, I am thankful. And lastly, I want to thank God above. He gives me a sign with each patient I handle that this is truly the profession I was created for. Graduate practical nurse, Caitlin Edwards.
Raven Eisenberger. Raven was on the president's list for fall semester 2019 and spring semester 2020.
Raven has been pinned by her best friend, Daniel Jackson. Raven would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her in this endeavor. Graduate practical nurse, Raven Eisenberger.
Addison Charlene Head. Addison served as the secretary for the practical nursing class.
Addison is being pinned by her mother, Emily Koch. Addison wants to thank her parents for supporting her. She also would like to thank her close friends that she has made during this year while in school. Addison says this year has flown by, and she also said she is so glad it is over. Graduate practical nurse, Addison Head.
Brooke Nicole Heron. Brooke served as the vice president for the practical nursing class. She was the recipient of the Tom and Fern Swetna Memorial Nurse Scholarship for spring semester 2020.
Jay Robbins.
Brooke has been pinned by her brother Brody and Grandma Jeannie. Here are Brooke's words. There are many people I'd like to thank, but I'm going to keep this short and sweet, because ain't nobody got time for that. Thank you to my parents, Mike and Tanya, and my grandparents, John and Jeannie, for their support on this journey. Thank you to Alex and Dakota for the grace you both gave me when I was busy with homework and working weekends. Thank you to Bobby Jameson, Sarah Madison, Raven Eisenberger, Jessica Young, and the Monroe County Sheriff deputies, Dana, Tony, and Jesse, for keeping me sane. A big thanks to my instructors, Bixel, Blackford, and Sullivan. Truly, without you guys, I would not have had the tools and education needed to be a successful nurse. Thank you to everyone who has been rooting in my corner. I hope I can continue to make you proud. Graduate practical nurse, Brooke Heron.
Shayna Howitt. Shayna was on the president's list for fall semester 2019 and spring semester 2020. She was the recipient of the New Traditions Scholarship for Displaced Homemakers for fall semester 2019 and spring semester 2020. Shayna assisted in putting together the photo montage that was presented during this evening's ceremony.
Shayna has been pinned by her sons, specifically Gavin Martin. Shayna wants to thank her parents for their support throughout this year, her children for keeping her motivated to better herself, and most of all, God for calling her to be a nurse and providing the means to become one. Shayna says there are many people God has put in her life that have made this year possible for her. There are too many to say, but she does want to thank Barb for rescuing her during clinicals, and Kim, thank you for being in her corner from day one. Graduate practical nurse, Shayna Howitt. Christina Lee Johnmeyer. Christina is being pinned by her sister, Madison Markland, who is in the BSN program at Columbia College, along with their younger sister, Carolyn. Christina would like to thank her classmates for coming to class each day, willing and ready to learn. She says she could not have made it this far without you. She would also like to thank her family for their love and support. Graduate practical nurse, Christina Johnmeyer.
Carlena Ashton Kinder. Carlena served on the historian committee for the practical nursing class.
Carlena is being pinned by her father, David Kinder. Carlena would like me to read the following this evening. First, I would like to start off by saying thank you to our instructors for their outpouring support, positivity, and encouragement throughout the year. You have taught and wanted the best for me since day one, and I couldn't have finished this program successfully without you. You are all great role models, and I hope that one day I can be as great of a nurse as you. Next, I would like to thank my family, especially my mom and dad, for their constant support and encouragement throughout this program. This has been a long, hard, and bumpy year, and I can't thank you enough for always believing in me. I would not be where I am today without you two. Now I can thank my siblings, Jeffrey, for always turning my bad days into good ones with his hysterical jokes. Jarrett for challenging me on each exam and bragging about not having to go back to school. Kiana for always keeping me in check with what is mine and not hers. Then I would like to thank my boyfriend Riley for constantly believing in me and always wishing me luck before every test. Even at a distance, you still manage to take time out of your day to hype me up for each exam. I would like to thank my lovely dog and study buddy, all in one, Willow, for always keeping me on my toes, literally, because she never minded. And last, I would like to thank my classmates who have become family for battling through to the end and pushing and motivating me to strive for my best. Even at my worst, you've always managed to pick me right up to do better the next time. You guys rock, and I can't wait to watch all of you succeed as a nurse. Graduate practical nurse, Carlena Kinder.
I would like to announce this evening that academic excellence is going to be given to a student, and Carlina Kinder is the student that we're going to give that to. It's awarded to a practical nursing student who has obtained the highest cumulative GPA during this academic year. Congratulations, Carlina Kinder. Jason Roy Lowry Jr. Jason served as our president for the practical nursing class and was selected as an alternate for the Thelma Shaw Memorial Scholarship during the fall semester 2019.
Jason is being penned by his wife, Amanda Lowry, RN, who is a former graduate of MACC's practical nursing program as well. Jason would like to start off by thanking his wife for standing by him as he took this journey. He says you are his inspiration, his motivation, and the best nurse he knows. He said he couldn't have done this without you. And to Jason's children, he wants this to be proof that no matter your age or where you are in life, you can still accomplish your goals. To his family, Jason says, "No, I don't know what that rash is. And no, I don't want to have a look, but thank you for believing in me." To Jason's friends, he says, "Thanks for your support this past year." He says everyone believed in him even when he had his doubts. Jason says the following, "You are my people and I love you all so much." Jason says he's lost some very special people to him this past year, as if nursing school wasn't enough. But he says he knows his Papa John, Uncle Johnny, and Curtis are all smiling and cheering him on today from heaven. Last, Jason would like to thank and congratulate his classmates who have made it here with him. We did it! Graduate practical nurse, Jason Lowry. Mary McGee. Mary is being penned by her sister, Danielle Sommerfeld, RN. Danielle is also a former graduate of MACC's practical nursing program. Mary would like to thank an abundance of people who have supported her and pushed her through this year of schooling. And they are her parents, Brian and Wendy McGee, for pushing her and telling her how proud they are every day. Her sister and her sister's husband, Carl and Danielle, for constantly letting her study with them and telling her all about Danielle's crazy adventures during nursing school. Hunter Horner for hearing her daily rants about literally everything from neuro to cardiac to GI, and for always being there no matter how crabby she was with school. Mary says, "This is your chance to all say, I told you so." Mary wants to thank her professors, Miss Bixel, for being the quiz queen, which ended up helping her immensely in OB, especially now that she will be working in that field at MU. To Mrs. Sullivan for always lending a helping hand when needed during clinicals or lectures, and her use of the word ew at everything, jokingly at least. Lastly, she would like to thank Mrs. Blackford, who is the teacher that pushes you because she knows you will be a great nurse. She doesn't let you off easily with a generic answer, and she wants you to know the rationale behind everything, because anyone can open a book and say the correct answer, but only a nurse can tell you why. Graduate practical nurse, Mary McGee.
Reese Carissa Robbins. Reese served on the cheer committee for the practical nursing class.
Reese is being penned by her mother, Carrie Robbins. Reese wants to thank her parents for always giving her love and support, no matter how far away. Many things couldn't have been possible without you. Thank you to her family that brought her in and made her feel like their own, And thank you to everyone who has helped her get to this point. Graduate practical nurse, Reese Robbins.
Courtney Schirmerhorn served on the historian committee for the practical nursing class and was the recipient of the Charles H. and Margaret L. Harding Scholarship for fall semester 2019. Courtney assisted in putting together the photo montage that was presented during this evening's ceremony. The second award that we are going to give this evening is for clinical excellence. It is awarded to a practical nursing student who has demonstrated a consistent growth in the clinical setting. This student displayed professionalism, leadership, critical thinking, the ability to work with others, excellent dedication to client care, and strong communication skills. This year's recipient is Courtney Schirmerhorn. Congratulations.
Courtney has been penned by her husband and daughter, Taylor and Emery Schirmerhorn. Here are Courtney's words. Isaiah 41:10 says, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." I remember coming into the PN program with fear of the unknown, fear of failing, fear of letting my family and God himself down. I remember within the first week of the program, Ms. Bixel handed each one of us a little card and we were to write a quote. This Bible verse is what immediately consumed me in that moment and has branded my existence throughout the program and held true throughout my lifetime. First, I want to thank God for always holding true to his promises and never giving up on me. I want to thank the instructors for believing in me when I didn't believe in myself. I then want to thank my family, friends, and my in-laws for encouraging me throughout this program. I honestly wish I could thank every single one of you, but then none of us would graduate tonight because we would be here all evening. I love each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart, and I pray that you each know that. To my husband, I want you to know that I appreciate all the sacrifices you have made and your work ethic to ensure my success in the program. I am blessed to be able to love you every day and for the rest of our lives. Most importantly, I want to thank our daughter, Emery Jane. You may never remember mommy going to nursing school, but I will always remember that I did it all because of you. Giving birth to you brought me here. Wanting to give you a life you deserve pushed me through. You are my light, my world, my baby, my everything. I will always love you. Graduate practical nurse, Courtney Schirmerhorn.
Erin Kale Schleimacher served as our treasurer for the practical nursing class.
Erin is being penned by her mother, Joanne Mackey. First off, Erin would like to thank MACC for giving her the amazing opportunity of becoming a nurse through them. In keeping with saying MACC, there wouldn't be a PN program without the instructors. She would like to thank them for believing in her and giving her courage throughout these challenging times. Thank you to her family who has pushed Erin to do her best, who has stayed up late with her to help her study, and who has given Erin a shoulder to cry on when she needed it. Erin wants to say thank you to her amazing friends that she has made throughout the program. She says without you guys, she probably would have no hair left. She said she could have done without the extra 15 pounds that you all gained from carb loading before exams, though she seriously does not think she could have made it without you guys. And she says she is very blessed to be able to call you all lifelong friends. Graduate practical nurse, Erin Schleiermacher. Miranda White. Miranda is being penned by her son, Benjamin. Miranda wrote a letter for her thank you this evening, and here it is. At last, the time has come that I have been waiting for graduation. As we all know, this is not my first time in the program. It has been a long 2 years of working towards this moment. I wanted to take the time to thank my family for all the support they have given me over this time. I don't know how I would have done it without you. From giving my kids rides to school, watching them so I could study, and to watching them so I could have a meltdown. Multiple meltdowns. To say the least, it has been an emotional roller coaster. I want to thank my kids for being patient with me even when I was not in the best of moods. I could hear the whispers from the other room trying to keep each other quiet so that mom could study or take an exam. I hope that I have shown them no matter your circumstances, you can do anything you put your mind to and to never give up. Last but not least, I would like to thank my instructors. Thank you for always being there to give me encouragement when I needed it the most. It meant more than you know. I sincerely appreciate the advice you have given me through the program. Again, thank you all for the love and support. Yours truly, Miranda White, GPN. Graduate practical nurse, Miranda White.
Jessica Louise Young. Jessica was on the dean's list for fall semester 2019 and on the president's list for spring semester 2020. She served as the health science student representative for the practical nursing class. Jessica was the recipient of the Thelma Shaw Memorial Scholarship for fall, spring, and summer semesters for 2019-2020, and she was the recipient of the Kimberly Lee Ann Enix Memorial Scholarship for spring semester 2020.
Jessica was penned by Addison, her daughter. Jessica's thank you is as follows. There are many people I would like to thank. It's hard to know where to begin. First off, to my great family. My dad for being so amazing and encouraging my whole life. My brother for being an amazing person, always setting an example of strength. My mom for always encouraging and telling me I can be anything I want to be. My sister from always making me laugh when I'm stressed out. And my mother-in-law for never forgetting to tell me how proud she is of me. To my friends, Reagan and Audrey, who listened to the endless nursing school questions I had even before I began school, and for always telling me I could totally do this. My nursing school besties, Brooke, Carlena, Christina, and Raven, you guys are seriously the best, and I am so glad I got to share this experience with you. All the million questions, the long list of to-dos for class, and the ridiculous conversations had outside of class. I love you guys. My teachers and the health sciences department staff, you guys are so great. We know this has been a very trying semester, and we appreciate all the hard work and long nights we are certain you put in. To Sonda for always reminding me that no matter how busy life gets, I am never too busy to help someone less fortunate. Mrs. Blackford, you are so funny and amazing at your job. Your passion for your work is absolutely undeniable, but what I loved most about you is how you share your personal experiences about your family. Your love for them shines through in all that you do, and your ability to bring humor to any situation is wonderful. Mrs. Sullivan, you are so kind and so amazing. You're firm, and yet you're gentle in your teaching all at the same time. Have you ever just met someone in life and knew they were exactly where God intended them to be? Because you are exactly where you are meant to be. You are so great at your job, and I am so glad to have been able to have had you as an instructor. Ms. Bixel, in all of nursing instructors in all of the world, I cannot imagine there is another instructor who pours more of her heart and time into her teaching. You are so thorough and passionate about your work. You are truly an amazing woman and instructor. You always go the extra mile to make sure we all had the knowledge and we all were successful. Thank you to my husband. Without you, none of this would be possible. I love you more than words could ever express. You are always supporting me and encouraging me to do whatever I want to do. Staying up late with me when I had gobs of homework, cooking dinner so I could study, taking care of all the children's needs so I could finish care plans, making sure I had a desk in a quiet place to study, You have always been my biggest supporter and I love you. And to my kids, thank you for being my motivation to always do better and be better. Thank you for understanding when I had work to do and could not go play with you, or when I was cranky because I had a stressful day. You are my whole world. This is not just my special day. This is our special day, because without all of you, I would not be here today celebrating this victory. Thank you. Graduate practical nurse, Jessica Young.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and lead in the practical nurses pledge. So if everyone at home, or all our nurses at home. Good. Go ahead and just follow along with us. Before God and those assembled here, I solemnly pledge to adhere to the code of ethics of the nursing profession, to cooperate loyally with all other members of the nursing team, and to carry out faithfully and to the best of my ability my instructions of the physician or the nurse who may be assigned to supervise my work. I will not do anything evil or malicious, and I will not knowingly give any harmful drug or assist in malpractice. I will not reveal any confidential information that may come to my knowledge in my course of work. And I pledge myself to do all in my power to raise the standards and the prestige of practical nursing. May my life be devoted to service and to high ideas of the nursing profession.
At this time, I would like to introduce the 2019-2020 graduates for the practical nursing program at Moberly Area Community College. Congratulations.
Yay.